Torch the bland suburban's play.
After the first thing called the human being, that thing was like, yeah, there is a community. We're all those people who were the weird ones, you know. And it was all of a sudden you discovered all these people who were like you, influenced by the beatniks.
Don't eat those, Ma. They're Alice B. Toklas, bro.
I love you, Alice B. Toklas.
We would all like to be able to live an uncluttered life, if you know, and like think about moving the whole human race ahead a step.
These young people were looking for a spiritual way to rebel against the American values, almost as an extension of what we'd begun doing in the 50s. They sort of looked on us as the elders of the tribe.
I mean, what is your whole attitude to life? And when you meet somebody, what is your attitude towards them?
I don't like them.
You don't?
No.
Sometimes the caring manifests itself as anger or other feelings that you might think of as negative. Anything that has a strong charge is where your heart is lying.
I think that the Vietnamese War is nothing but a plot between the North Vietnamese and the South Vietnamese, who are cousins, to get jeeps in the country.
They're not very good plotters, are they?
But they got a lot of jeeps.
We were rebelling against a kind of rigidity in the culture, and the Beats seemed to point out that there were lots of room in the U.S. Constitution for more freedom.
We are going to Chicago, about a quarter of a million of young, energetic love buddies, to engage in a youth international party, sing in, grope in, love in.
Which is really heightened is a consciousness which takes action.
And are you expecting trouble?
We expect to march.
We expect
trouble all the time.
A whole generation was systematically cut off from outlets to personal meaning. We could play the game, but what was it about? No one knew.
The policeman isn't there to create disorder. The policeman is there to preserve disorder.
So we went with our more non-conforming impulse.
The Beats were originally non-political. Others who were political were really following the Beat movement to its logical conclusion.
He was wonderful.
He was an honored presence.
They had a vision, and the vision was truth, justice, and the American way. Just like the guy with the cape. They were the supermen and superwomen of our era.
Ground was really set in a way by the people who had helped us realize that we didn't have to follow what our elders told us, if we really didn't think it was right. I couldn't get naked on somebody's front lawn and get myself arrested. It wasn't my style, but I really admired that.
Born of distant dark planet names, I word wooden, I spell it away! Mega, 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 death bomb in lighthouse!
There's a time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part.
I always thought that what we were doing was a patriotic act. Who has always been out there, old crazy coots that keep out on the edge of where civilization is gone? I think a lot of this comes from Cassidy and from Kerouac. Cassidy was our driver. He knew that this was going to be the best stage he was ever going to have to do his number. Never mind all that reflection. Let's see who we are. Let's turn the thing on as bright as it'll go and then see what kind of shadow we cast.
I put my back toward the screen and then spun and let the momentum carry the panel through the screen and window with a ripping crash. The glass splashed out in the moon like a bright, cold water baptizing the sleeping earth. I put my hand on the sill and vaulted after the panel into the moonlight.
Mr. Kesey, do you feel that you have the right to do what you want, whatever you want, and still live in this world?
I feel a man has the right to be as big as he feels it in him to be.
Death of Neil Cassidy at San Miguel de Allende, where he died walking along the railroad tracks after getting stoned and whatever. You know, uppers and downers at the same time. He wasn't destined to grow old. He was always young and he always will be. 100 years ago, he would have been on a horse. But his hot rod was his horse.
Delicate eyes that blinked blue Rockies all ash. Nipples, ribs I touched with my thumb or ash. Mouth my tongue touched once or twice, all ash. Our existence is so brief as we understood it that it becomes more poignant. More emotionally rich, knowing that it's like a dream that is already finished, as Kerouac once said. Life is a dream already over.
Jack suddenly one morning had a hemorrhage, apparently brought on by years and years of consuming alcohol, which I guess is the typical alcoholic's death.
America by his day was sick. Hard-heartedness had taken over. So I would say America broke his heart. You just have to read the reviews of his books in those days. You know, he was put down. It was as if, you know, like knifed. And yet he was writing about enthusiasm and delight. And he was being treated like some juvenile delinquent.
Now, Jack, Mr. Kerouac, to what extent do you believe that the beat generation is related to the hippies?
Oh,
what do they have in common? Was this an evolution from the one to the other?
It's just the older ones.
Yeah.
See, I'm 46 years old. These kids are 18. It's the same movement, which is apparently some kind of Dionysian movement in late civilization. And which I did not intend any more than I suppose Dionysius did, or whatever his name was.
Hey, that was good, wasn't it?
Good all the time, boy.
Give that man a drink.
Spent all the night with poets and so on. He drank and all that. And well, I said, aren't you afraid of hell? He says, oh, no. He says, I'm concerned with heaven. He says, I'm thinking about heaven all the time. I want to see Gerard, my little brother.
He'd already scribed 1,000 dreams, 1,000 pages of Dharma, 1,000,000 words that sounded like 1,000,000 ears. His heart was tender. He'd already died and become recording angel.
Jack Kerouac, the novelist who wrote On the Road, reached the end of it today. The 47-year-old spokesman for the Beat Generation died of a massive hemorrhage in a St. Petersburg, Florida hospital.
And what love. All my thoughts of you, for I'm so completely yours.
All the people that leave this stuff here, it's their way. You know, it's their way of coming here. It's part of their path, you know. It's like 13-year-old kids, college kids, guys my age, old-timers. Wicked spectrum.
So, that's what's gonna happen to you?
No, I wanna be in an unmarked grave.
What do you think Jack would have felt about doing all this?
Yeah, he would have grooved on this stuff.
Why?
Because this stuff comes from the heart, and that's where he was coming from.
I believe in order, tenderness, and piety.
Well, then your point was that a movement which you conceived as relatively pure has become ideologized.
No, a movement that was considered what?
Pure.
Yes, it was pure in my heart.
Don't explain.
Belief and Technique for Modern Prose by Jack Kerouac. List of essentials. 1. Scribbled secret notebooks and wild typewritten pages for your own joy. 2. Submissive to everything, open, listening. 3. Try and never get drunk outside your own house. 4. Be in love with your life. 5. Something that you feel will find its own form. 6. Be crazy, dumb saint of the mind. 7. Blow as deep as you want to blow. 8. Write what you want, bottomless, from bottom of the mind. 9. The unspeakable visions of the individual. Dean was in a trance. The tenorman's eyes were fixed straight on him. He had a madman who not only understood, but cared and wanted to understand more, and much more than there was. The tenorman wore a tattered suede jacket, purple shirt, cracked shoes, and zoot pants without press. He didn't care. His big brown eyes were concerned with sadness and the singing of songs slowly and with long, thoughtful pauses. His mouth quivered. He looked at us, Dean and me, with an expression that seemed to say, hey now, what's this thing we're all doing in this sad brown world? And then he came to the end of his song, and for this there had to be elaborate preparations. During which time you could send all the messages to Garcia around the world 12 times, and what difference did it make to anyone? Because here we were dealing with the pit and prune juice of poor beat life itself and the god-awful streets of man. He sat in the corner with a bunch of boys and paid no attention to them. He looked down and wept. He was the greatest. I had put the light out, so in the dark, dancing, I kissed her. It was giddy whirling to the dance. The beginning. The usual beginning of lovers kissing, standing up in a dark room. The room being the woman's, the man all designs. Quick to plunge, bite, put the light out, hide my face in shame. Make love to her tremendously because of lack of love for a year almost, and the need pushing me down. Our little agreements in the dark really should not be told. For it was she who later said, men are so crazy, they want the essence. The woman is the essence. There it is, right in their hands, but they rush off erecting big, abstract constructions. But I cannot, in this confession, betray the innermost, the thighs, what the thighs contain. The thighs contain the essence. Yet though there I should stay, and from there I came, and will eventually return, still, I have to rush off and construct. Construct for nothing. For Baudelaire poems.
This is just his bones here. His spirit's around us.
I'd like an omelet, plain, and a chicken salad sandwich on wheat toast.
16 years ago, we were put down for being filthy beatnik sex commie dope fiends.
Now all you have to do is hold the chicken, bring me the toast, give me a check for the chicken salad sandwich, and you haven't broken any rules.
You see that sign, sir?
You see this sign?
16 years later, Allen's the respect of his elders, the love of his peers.
Do you have nostalgia for the 50s and 60s, Allen?
Not at all. It's more interesting now. I mean, it's all the 50s, 60s, 70s, same thing as now. It's eternity all the time, so there's no point having nostalgia for eternity.
Bill's ever Bill, even though he stopped drugging and smoking cigarettes.
I'm very pleased tonight to introduce a man who, in my opinion, is the greatest living writer in America.
Me? I'm still considered an unwashed beatnik sex commie.